everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing my favorite romance books with you guys. I hope you had a chance to watch my favorite thrillers video. Today I'm sharing my favorite romance books with you, and then I will share my favorite poetry and my favorite contemporary. It's a little series I'm doing on my channel. You guys are always asking me for recommendations. I stick with a very small set of genres, so I figured I'll just put out a favorites for all the genres that I read. I do read outside of my genres, but it's very rare, and I have very few that would fit into like a favorite. So today, favorite romance, get ready. I don't know if you're like me and you read romance and contemporary a lot in the summer, but I do. But maybe you're looking for a good romance. You can always refer back to this list when you're in the mood for a romance. So I have quite a few. I'm going to do it just like I did my thriller video. I'm not doing full synopsis. I'm just like sharing some like buzzwords to get you excited about these. Let's go ahead and jump in with the first book. The first one on the very top of the stack is this really pretty graphic novel, Bloom, by Kevin Panetta and Savannah. I'm not sure how to say that last name, but this is a really cute graphic novel. It's about a boy and his family. They have this like bake shop, and the boy doesn't want to work at his family's shop. He wants to go to the big city. He wants to be a musician. So he decides to hire someone and train someone to take his spot so he can go and like play in the band and stuff. So he hires this guy, and they end up falling in love. Like a little romance blooms between them, and it's just really sweet, and I love the color palette and all of that. Highly recommend this one. I also love Christina Lauren, and more than one of their books are going to pop up on my list. The first one in the stack is Love in Other Words, and I really like this one. It's like a second chance romance. The main character's mom dies, and one of the things that her mom left behind a list for the dad that said she needs a place to get away sometimes. So he got this like house outside of town, and she met Elliot, and it tells of their romance in the past and the present, like a then and now. And I just really, really liked it. And I always recommend this to people looking for like a second chance romance story. Next up is Birthday Girl by Penelope Douglas. I did do a author taste test for Penelope Douglas, and I recommend this one more than Credence because both are kind of like taboo romances, but this one is a little bit more palatable because it's about, it's still taboo. It's about a girl that moves into her boyfriend's dad's house, and a romance kind of gets started between the girl and her boyfriend's dad. Recent read for me, a hate to love romance, The Trouble with Hating You by Sajni Patel, and I just loved this. I learned so much about Indian culture in this. I loved the food references, and I do love a good hate to love romance story. Next up is another graphic novel or comic, and this one is Heartstopper by Alice Osman. And I have read volumes 1 through 3, but I definitely want more. Mine are done in black and white. It's also available for free online as like a web comic, but I just really like the story. There's lots of representation, not just with our two main characters, but with the whole cast and crew. And I also like at the end, she does these little cards talking about the main characters in the story and like their Myers-Briggs and their Hogwarts house and just all of that, how everybody intertwines. And if you read Alice Osman's books, it also mentions these characters and other characters in this or in her other books. So it's kind of like this whole universe of characters and like world that you're reading about. Really like this one. Next up is The Unhoneymooners by Christina Lauren. I want to say that this is my favorite one. This is also a enemies to lovers or hate to love romance story about our main character Olive's sister. Well, Olive is getting, Olive is the unlucky twin. Her sister's getting married to this guy, and she's kind of enemies with the groom's brother, but then a string of things happen. They end up going on this honeymoon together, like this fake dating honeymoon, enemies to lovers. The banter is so funny. Olive is kind of like not that peppy, bubbly person, so I just really enjoyed that. I also want to mention these two together. It's On the Island by Tracy Garvis Graves and also Uncharted by Tracy Garvis Graves. I'm mentioning them together. This is the first book. This is like a little follow-up novella because it's really short, but even together it's pretty short. So I highly recommend you just go ahead and pick up both of them because you're gonna want to know what happens after this, and this tells that story. This is another taboo romance about, it's a family that hires a tutor for their son, and they're going to spend the summer and the summer in Maldives, and they go and there's like a plane crash, and then the tutor and the boy get stranded on an island, and yeah, things happen. Next up is November 9 by Colleen Hoover. This will also not be the only Colleen Hoover on this list because I just love her as an author. Like, I definitely find authors that I like and I just like read all of their books. Christina Lauren, Colleen Hoover, Taylor Jenkins Reid. Yeah, those are some romance authors. So in this one, I like it. It tells a romance only on one day a year, but over several years. So on November 9th, they agree to meet and things happen and you're getting their life and their relationship updated every November 9th. Another more recent read is Beach Read by Emily Henry. I really liked this one because although it is about a new love, they also have pasts and kind of complicated baggage pasts that they have to deal with, and they don't bring that to the new relationship. They deal with it on their own. So I really liked this one. Get a Life, Chloe Brown by Talia Hibbert. I think I was like the first one in my friend group to read this book and I was raving about it, and I feel like everybody's reading this now, which is great, but like I'm an OG lover of Talia Hibbert and I haven't picked up Danny Brown yet, but I really, really want to. If anybody wants to gift it to me, I'm all ears. But I just really like this. Our main character has chronic illness, chronic pain, and she had this like accident or her life flashed before her eyes. So she makes this list to make her life more exciting, and red helps her accomplish some things on that list. Next up is The Simple Wild by K.A. Tucker, which I think is still the only K.A. Tucker book I've read. I haven't picked up the sequel to this yet, but I plan to at some point. This one is about our main character, Calla Fletcher, who goes to the Alaska wilderness to see her dad. Like, he's been diagnosed with cancer and he's dying, and it's kind of like go to there, see, you know, kind of like final words. Next up, I haven't read this one in quite a while, so I'm not sure like if it would still be a favorite, but it was back in the day and I always think about it when people ask for recommendations. So The Hating Game by Sally Thorne is an office hate to love romance. They're up for their executive assistants to co-CEOs, and they're like up for promotion or something like that, and the girl is wears bright clothes, she's quirky, she has a Pollyanna attitude, and yeah, they're up for the same promotion. So really like this one if you like hate to love. A YA recommendation I have for you is Starry Eyes by Jen Bennett. She's definitely like my go-to contemporary romance writer for YA. I love this one. This one's set in like Northern California in like the woods, and there's like camping involved, and it's just really, really sweet. They were like best friends and now they're not, and like what happened and you know all that. The Bromance Book Club, which is also a more recent read, but I love this one. It's a married couple that's dealing with some things, and Gavin, the main character, like he has a group of like alpha males, and they have this like a romance book club. And they use those books to like help their marriage. Really, really cute. This one I haven't read in a while. It Ends With Us by Colleen Hoover, but it's about this girl, Lily, who finds this like perfect guy. Like everything is great. He's a neurosurgeon. Everything seems too good to be true. But then in the past, this guy, Atlas, they had like a thing when they were younger, and now it's kind of like a love triangle, but like which one's better for her. And I don't know, I just really loved it. Maybe in Another Life by Taylor Jenkins Reid, also a favorite. This one is about, let's see, 29-year-old Hannah Martin. She is kind of down on her luck. Her life is just like crap. So she moves home to her hometown in Los Angeles, and her friend Gabby takes her out for like a night of fun. And she bumps into like an old like guy, like Ethan. I don't know if it's like her old high school boyfriend. And then she has a chance to either go home with Gabby or stay and like party with Ethan a little bit longer. So instead of like actually having to choose, her life splits and you see what happens if she chose to go home with Gabby and what happens if she stayed and partied a little bit longer with Ethan. So you get to see her life play out in two different, you know, time periods or two different paths. So I thought that was really cool. Also, Taylor Jenkins wrote The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. This one is a little bit more like historical fiction-y kind of too. It's about a woman named Evelyn Hugo who's like a really famous movie star, and she's had seven husbands, but you also find out about like who her one true love was. So I just really like that. And I like that you get to see several different relationships like throughout that story. Another one by Christina Lauren is Josh and Hazel's Guide to Not Dating. I think Hazel is such a quirky, relatable character. It's not like overly done, but this is more of a friends to lovers. It's so like innocent and believable how it happens. So my first Taylor Jenkins Reid book that I ever read, and it's probably one of my favorites, is One True Loves. And it's about a woman that marries this guy. They have a wonderful, perfect marriage, but on their 1-year wedding anniversary, he gets an assignment of a lifetime, and he, like, the plane goes down and he's presumed dead. And so she's putting her life back together. She moves home. She bumps into like an old friend / coworker, and now they're engaged to be married. And surprise, her husband is found. And now she has to choose between her husband and this new guy and which one's better for her. So very interesting. For those that say that like love triangles aren't real, read that book. Next up is One Day in December by Josie Silver. I did read Josie Silver's new book. I didn't really like that one, but I really liked this one. You don't have to wait for Christmas time, but you can if you want. A woman sees a man at a bus stop, and she just feels like an instant like magnetism pull towards him, and her best friend like search for this guy for several months. But then at the Christmas party, who walks through the door as her best friend's like significant other? The guy that she saw at the bus stop. So you're either gonna love this one or hate this one, because like you are dealing with this magnetism between these two people, but it's also like her best friend's boyfriend. I don't know, it deals with some touchy things, but I really liked it. Okay, next up, another book that I talk about so often for good reason, All Your Perfects by Colleen Hoover. Let me show you that my copy is signed. So Colleen sent this to me because it's such a personal story to me. It's about a marriage that is imperfect, and at the center of that is infertility, and it's just so emotional and it's so realistic. So if you're looking for like a married couple romance, this is the one. Let's see, The Proposal by Jasmine Guillory. Really liked this one. It's about a girl that goes with her boyfriend at the time to a baseball game, and he proposes to her without like her knowing or anything. And she's like, what the heck? Like, no. And this guy just randomly saves her and offers her a ride home. And then a romance kind of ensues between those two. And it's just really, really cute. Next up, I have both of Helen Wong's books here. So The Kiss Quotient is the first one, and The Bride Test is the second one. These books all kind of do, they're part of the same series, so they definitely do like overlap a little bit, but the main characters in each are obviously different. So in this one, you have, Stella Lane, and she has like Asperger's, and so she's not really like lucky in love. She doesn't know how to like make that connection, so she hires like this escort guy to like help her in relationships. It's really, really good. And then in the second one, it's Esme. So Kai's mom goes to Vietnam and like propositions Esme to come like stay with her son, and it's like an arranged marriage type of thing. But then they both kind of realize things about themselves and they really do start liking each other. So that one's really, really good. And the new one, what's it called? The Something Principle. The Heart of the Principal, or I don't know. I'm gonna try to flash it on screen for you guys. That comes out in 2021 and I am so excited. Next up, I'll talk about these two together. So you have First Touch and Last Kiss by Lauralyn Page. And these are about, it's just the two books, but it's about a girl that, like her best friend and her, they kind of have like a code word that they use, like if they're ever in trouble. And one day her friend calls and leaves like a voicemail or something like that, and she says like this code word. So she's trying to track down her friend Amber, and she follows a chain of clues that leads her to this guy who's like a billionaire, and things take off from there. I have Forever Interrupted by Taylor Jenkins Reid, which I wasn't sure that I wanted to put this on the list. It starts off with Elsie and Ben, and they have this like supernova perfect meeting, perfect thing, and then they get married, and it's like a wonderful, you know, everything's perfect, like fairy tale perfect. But 9 days after getting married, Ben is out riding his bike when he's hit by a truck and he's killed on impact. So really it's Elsie and Ben's charmed romance without, like, it's mixed with like their perfect relationship. Obviously it's over now, but Elsie and Susan, Ben's mom, kind of healing together and processing everything that happened. So it's not really like your traditional romance story. It does have romance elements in it, but it's also about like learning to love yourself and the grieving process. And the next one is another YA story by Jen Bennett. This one is Serious Moonlight. These two people meet in a cafe in the very beginning. Kind of crazy how they meet. And then they're co-workers. This one has a lot to do with like mysteries and stuff, because they both end up working at this hotel and they're trying to like solve a mystery together. And the girl is really into like Nancy Drew and classic mysteries and stuff like that. So I really like this one. Two more for you. The next one is The Flatshare by Beth O'Leary. This one was a little hard to get into at first because the two perspectives are written so differently. You have Tiffy and Leon, and Tiffy's are written more traditional and Leon's are written very like stream of conscious, bullet point, no quotations, that sort of thing. But these two end up agreeing to share a flat and a bed because one needs the flat during the day and the other one needs it at night, and they start leaving little notes for each other, and it's just so cute. Last one is probably one of my all-time favorites of all time. Like any romance, definitely read this one if you haven't. And that is After I Do by Taylor Jenkins Reid. I've read this a couple of times now. This is the book I always read at like the first of the year, because I always heard it's a good idea to read like your favorite book, the first book in a new year, and you like start the reading year off right. So I highly recommend you try that. And this one, you have again a married couple that they're just kind of like nitpicking, and it's not like as smooth. They're not in that honeymoon phase anymore. Like things are getting real. And in this one, they decide that they're going to take a break. It's like an unconventional plan. We're going to separate for a year. There's only one rule. They cannot contact each other for 1 year. And during that time, anything goes. So it's about them finding themselves during that time. And you only get Lauren's really perspective, but things happen. And it's just really emotional. It's really good. It's about finding yourself as well as like learning about their marriage and things like that. So those are my romance recommendations. There were quite a few. Let me know which ones you're really excited to check out. Let me know your favorite romance books down in the comment section down below. Also look out for my contemporary favorites and my poetry favorites, which will be coming soon. But that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you're having a lovely day or night, and I'll see you guys again soon. Bye!